Hey, this is Paul, and today I'm going to do a review on purple flower O. camponis. The fruit is weighing in at just under a pound, and the orange flower O. camponis, which is weighing over a half a pound. Now, first, look at this stunning purple flower O. camponis flower. It's really beautiful, and the fruit is really stunning as well. It's probably one of the prettiest dragon fruit, looking wise, aesthetically. Look at that. It's like a dragon's egg. And then the orange flower O. camponis, a little bit smaller fruit. This is first season fruit on both of them for me, so I'm interested to try them. And you can see this orange flower O. camponis as well. It's a really pretty flower. And they both do pretty well. These come from Mexico, and they are a type of Hylocereus O. camponis. El Grullo has been my favorite one, and these tend to have a very dense flesh. Red flesh, self-sterile, and sometimes they'll taste like sweet beets to me. And look at that, that's a beautiful red flesh, full of antioxidants. Look at that. So dark you can barely see the seeds. Wow. And up to the left, I have a no idea, unknown Guatemalensis, a Guatemalan type, which I really like. Probably my favorite variety. And this one has a little bit more seeds. It probably is not going to taste as good since it's the first season. It probably could have been on the plant a little bit longer. See how the thickness of the skin is a little thicker? And I can definitely smell it from here. It smells like vegetables. And the orange one smells more like vegetables. And that one on the left smells a little bit earthy, like a beet. But I've had quite a few O. camponis. So I know what to expect. Let's just dive in for it. So I'm gonna take this corner slice to see. It's definitely more dense, I can already tell you, but this one's juicy. And I don't like it. I had to spit it out, sorry. It tastes a bit astringent to me. Ooh, like soapy beets. Let's test the sweetness. There is some sweetness to it. But, ooh, it's an acquired taste. I'd like to say it tastes good, but I would be lying. Ooh. All right, I'm a little afraid of the next bite, I hate to say, to be honest with you. There's a little bit of water in there. Let me get it out. There we go. So 16. All right, I'm gonna go for it. I mean, this is ripe. It is a pretty plant. All right, let's see if I can swallow this. It's just kind of astringent to me. It's sweet. It's more mild the second go around. But I definitely don't like it. I would not recommend it, at least this first season. It's not my cup of tea. Let's see how the orange flower tastes. Orange one's tasting more mild. Still dense, really earthy. Okay. I had to spit that one out, I hate to say. These are not my cup of tea. Very pretty, more of an ornamental variety, in my opinion. Maybe these will taste better, but I have no desire to consume those. That is not something I enjoy. So I'm going to clean my palate with something I do, which is a Guatemalan variety, this magenta fleshed. That's a good way to clean your palate. Night and day. So some people really do enjoy this variety and these different types. But this one is the most astringent tasting. It reminds me of Hylocereus bronchensis, where It's just not an enjoyable thing to eat, I hate to say. Now, if I was starving, I would eat it, but I would take this one any day over that, flavor-wise, today. But these ones are just much more up my alley, which I really prefer. So, Guatemalans. It's a pretty flower, pretty fruit. And I want to like it more. I really do. But just didn't do it for me. So there's my honest review off of my palate. Give us a like and a subscribe. Have a great day. Thanks for watching. Take care.